So sometimes we get stuck as integration partners where we're like, oh, it doesn't do this very niche specific thing that I'd want to do with my integration. Well, go look for a minute. Go try, because it's really hard for Google as a platform to support everything one off. But you'd be surprised the kind of things that you can do that are very compelling for your users.
Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer Spotlight. Today in the spotlight with me is Taylor Lykins, Product Manager at Lucid Software. Taylor, welcome to the show.
Hey, I'm so excited to be here. Thanks for having me.
Taylor, tell us, what do you do in your role as Product Manager at Lucid Software?
So Chanel, as a Product Manager at Lucid, I specifically support dev platform. And so I focus on expanding how our visual collaboration tools integrate into workflows our customers already use every day outside of Lucid. And so my role involves a lot of identifying opportunities where Lucid can add value within existing ecosystems like Google Workspace, and then working cross-functionally, not just within Lucid, but outside of Lucid, to bring those integrations to life. So I spend a lot of time talking to customers about their pain points and figuring out how to help solve those pain points using integrations with Lucid. It's a lot of fun working with integration partners, especially as we think strategically with how work is changing with remote work and AI, and how work is done across a bunch of different tools. We're big believers of survival of the friendliest, especially with the dominance of AI. We're seeing the need and importance of context and information moving freely, but also the absolute importance of human-to-human collaboration and interaction. Visually thinking is becoming essential for teams navigating increasing complexity. And so when you can quickly sketch out an idea or map a process or build your sprint out on the canvas, you're not just communicating differently, you're thinking differently. And this is where Lucid plus Google is really interesting with these complementary and natural workflows. And how can we tie these complementary experiences together so users can be empowered to do whatever it is that they're trying to do?
Lucid has several integrations which can be installed on the Google Workspace Marketplace. Tell us a little bit about the motivation behind creating these Google Workspace integrations.
For Lucid, anything we create is always about customer value. And so our motivation is always centered around creating value for our users. If we focus on customer value, then everything else will always follow. Users were working in Google and Lucid, but needed them to work together. There was a pain point and a problem with users' flows where they need to bounce between products and disrupt their flow, or they couldn't find the exact visual they needed in Google or embed a doc within a Lucid board to keep the context aggregated. There was a need for visuals from Lucid in Google Docs or slides so they could convey information or explain technical details and vice versa. There was a use case for having things written out, or a use case for having things visual on Canvas, and a use case for combining the two. And integrations could help support all three of those.
Now, what have you seen or heard from your customers about the value of having Lucid tools integrated with Google Workspace?
So for us, a lot of what we hear is more, which is a good problem to have. It's very compelling for technical teams to be able to have a written document within Google, whether docs or slides, that they can embed a Lucid document in to help explain technical requirements or the current state of something, or the architecture or a process, or to help drive alignment. There's just something unique about visuals that helps accelerate work. And so when users are inside the Google platform, they're always looking for ways to, maybe it's written over here, but now it can be visual someplace else. And so we realized that if we could embed Lucid Docs visual collaboration capabilities directly into Google Workspace, we could keep teams in their flow state while giving them powerful diagramming, brainstorming, agile, or process diagramming tools exactly when and where they need them. The goal is to make visual collaboration as natural as sending a message or sharing a document or writing a Word doc. You know, you can jump into Lucid and do the messy brainstorming part and then write it out in Google more concretely, then diagram that concrete plan out to visualize it, then execute against it in Lucid plus Google in whatever workflow works best for you. You know, it's so funny when we talk about getting work done or when we talk about understanding something, we use the phrase, oh, I see, to say that we understand something. We literally say, I see. And so with Lucid, you actually can see it. You can just visualize it. You can just diagram it out. We also use the phrase all the time, well, what does that look like, right? If you've ever been reading something that someone's written, you ask, well, what does that look like? Well, in Lucid, you can just show it. And so all the time, especially as we push more integrations, we use to say, well, now can it do this? Or could it do this? Or what else can we have this integration do for us to help us see or have these, oh, I see kind of moments?
Yeah, and I can really imagine also with teams, you know, that work globally and work online together, being able to see the visualization really makes a lot of sense. I also want to congratulate you because you recently launched Lucid Chart, Lucid Spark, and Lucid Scales, where now all three of these apps are also available for Google Chat. How have Workspace customers reacted to this? And are you able to, you know, share a little bit how this opened up new use cases for your applications?
Thank you. We're so excited that we got this launched for our entire Lucid platform. Our customers have appreciated having such easy access to the integration and how natural it feels to have Lucid just plug and play here. Communication platforms like Google Chat are really a unique place to have integrations, especially with remote work, like you pointed out a second ago. It's amazing how much context and decision-making there is in these sorts of tools. Google Chat is really compelling with how integrated it is within the Google platform as well, and the context that brings into these integrations and user workflows. This resonates with how Lucid users think about collaboration and how our users are wanting to use our integrations. This starts to open the door for new use cases, especially as work continues to evolve, not just with remote, but also with AI. And that's where this becomes a really fun and interesting conversation going forward. Lucid has a lot of context in technical diagramming, but also from brainstorming sessions or collaboration around executing or working or planning or whatever it is that you're actually trying to get done. And when you combine all the context and value within the context that is within the Google platform and within Lucid, that gives users a lot of valuable flows to potentially simplify, enhance, or even automate. Work is so fluid, and it's oftentimes really messy. Sometimes it happens on the fly in an ad hoc meeting. Sometimes work actually gets done even in a planned meeting. But we're entering a phase of technology where that shouldn't be a problem. Whether you decide to do something in a Google Meet or on a Lucid board or in Google Chat, you should be able to track, find, distribute, aggregate, summarize, whatever decisions are made or whatever things you figured out in any tool or across any part of the Google workspace. And we're starting to see that really come to life.
Yeah, very cool. And also for our viewers watching, Google Chat is super important for us working at Google too. I mean, also to connect with our partners and our customers, but especially we Googlers. I love how you said that, you know, so many decisions are made in Google Chat and it's super quick. And that's why I love how apps can be integrated into Google Chat. As a matter of fact, these chat apps that you just recently launched, you used a new capability that you can create Google Chat apps as Google Workspace add-ons. Now, how did Lucid benefit from this new capability?
We were so grateful for this. We thought this simplified things tremendously, not just from a technical standpoint, but also from the go-to-market side. This capability was exactly what we needed to deliver a seamless user experience quickly. The Workspace add-on framework let us leverage all of our existing Google Workspace integration architecture, which meant our customers got a very unified experience, again, particularly from the go-to-market side. It's also very important to be very security aware as you build integrations. We support a lot of enterprise customers. And so you always build enterprise security first, because that's very relevant, especially in the day of AI. And we chose to keep all the same scopes we offered for our other integrations for consistency and security sake. And that made it so easy for admins to be able to look at this and say, yeah, we're good, right? It's the same scopes and the same security and the same infrastructure as everything else that Google's offering. And from that distribution standpoint, we appreciate how just straightforward that was and how easy it was for the users. Oh, you have Google Workspace installed? Now you get this integration, just like that. I think it's such a great framework and so much easier for users to be able to wrap their heads around and get access to and just feel natural about, oh yeah, it's right here now, right? Because so much tech, the adoption play is tough. And if it's not where the user needs it or expects it, then you have a whole problem with where do you have them go find it? How do they know what the thing is? And this framework not only helps technically with actual delivery, but then again, that distribution and go-to-market play.
Now, can you tell us a little bit about the experience of, you know, building a Google Workspace add-on that extends Google Chat?
We genuinely found the experience great. The development experience felt very familiar because we were building on concepts we already knew from our other Google integrations. Honestly, the hardest part was just the PM UX stuff, which is, what does it look like? How does it feel inside of Google? And that's something you always got to remember when you're building integrations, is you're in somebody else's house. And so it needs to feel how their product feels. And there needs to be interactions for how people interact with their product. That was the hardest part. And it's not a problem. It's just something you want to make sure that you address. If users are used to or appreciate certain patterns of behavior, make sure that's what you support. And that's how users interact with your integration. From the technical side, the documentation and developer tools made the technical implementation straightforward. The add-on framework handled a lot of the complexity around authentication and such. It was really cool to see what Google's made available and what we could utilize and how creative we could be with what was available. The documentation, again, was very thorough. If we had a question, chances are it was in the documentation. We just needed to dig. So genuinely, the experience we thought was very optimal for us.
Do you have any tips or best practices for developers, how to use our tools, how to use our dev docs, any secret sauce that you've maybe found?
I don't know if we had any particular secret sauce other than just use it. Just really be aggressive with it and dive into it. It is very good. It is very helpful. It is very thorough. There's a high likelihood if you have a question, it's in there. And there's great functionality to go into utilize and be creative with that functionality, right? We found ways to implement features that we thought were unique for our integration just because of what was exposed and available via Google. And so sometimes we get stuck as integration partners where we're like, oh, it doesn't do this very niche specific thing that I'd want to do with my integration. Well, go look for a minute. Go try, because it's really hard for Google as a platform to support everything one-off. But you'd be surprised the kind of things that you can do that are very compelling for your users.
Now, a frequent question that I get from developers looking to build their Google Workspace add-on, very often the very first add-on, is which technology to use? So there's very often this question, AppScript versus HTTP endpoints. Do you have any guidance or any ideas on this technology selection?
My proposal would be use whatever makes the most sense for you. Google does support both, and they will be supportive in both. We chose AppScript because it aligned with our existing Google Workspace ecosystem, and it gave us the lightweight integrated experience we wanted. Since we already had Google Cloud Services powering our integrations, AppScript felt like the natural choice for us to use in this case. AppScript's integration with Google's Workspace infrastructure meant we didn't have to worry about hosting, scaling, or managing additional endpoints just for chat functionality. Plus, we're using the class tool for local development, which let us work in TypeScript and maintain our existing development workflows while still deploying to the AppScript environment. So for our specific needs, it made a ton of sense. And so I would definitely say just do that evaluation up front. Low cost and simplicity is typically the best option to go with.
Now, another frequent question, and this is also something you alluded to before, is go-to-market strategy. So let's say you have this amazing workspace integration, you put it up on the marketplace, and then what do you do? Do you have any ideas? Or also, can you talk maybe from experience? Because at a certain point, all of your Lucid software integrations were new on the marketplace too.
So the go-to-market motion is one of the toughest ones, because your engineering teams, they work so hard to build these really cool tools, and then users either don't know about them or you can't figure out how to reach them. We're really fortunate at Lucid to have an amazing marketing team and training team that can do things like webinars and trainings and can interact with influencers and show these new tools. We also get a lot of natural word of mouth. And frankly, that's the best way, because that's how you know if people are using your product, right? Because they just talk about it and they use it. I think it's helpful to break it into two parts. There is marketing for new users, so new customer acquisition, and marketing for current product users, so essentially expansion and driving adoption. And I would say always start with your current user base. The best marketing is a seamless user experience. When the integration feels essential rather than nice to have, users become your advocates and your marketing team. So if you don't have a lot of funds or a lot of availability to like get out into the market and do big webinars or any have a really strong long marketing reach, make your integration feel natural. So this is a lot of the product team, and a lot of the engineers working together to realize, okay, where is the specific flow that this should show up just naturally and just be there, right? It shouldn't have to be the user's like, oh, I need an integration that does X, Y, Z. And then they go and they Google, what is an integration that maybe does this? And hopefully you get rated and then you can find your thing. No, just make it so it's right there. Rather than trying to add a great big billboard on the highest traffic road possible, just be right there in that moment. And that takes research. And that takes talking to users and asking them, show me your flow, diagram it out for me. Where exactly would you need this? What would it look like? I think that's the best way to get your integration notice is that sort of thinking. When you do this, it almost feels magical for the user. And that's what we're looking for. For more broader marketing approaches, webinars are very powerful. They're really powerful for us. Partnerships are amazing if you can get those spun up and have good relationships with folks. Making sure that your marketplace listings are optimized for LLM discovery. I also think that's going to be a bigger play fairly soon, if not right now.
Yeah, I love those points. And they're also, they're very similar to what I've heard from other successful Google Workspace add-on builders. As a matter of fact, there's a super interesting developer spotlight episode with one of our Google developer experts, Amit Agarwal. I'll be linking that to the end of this video. So I highly recommend you check that out. And I love how you said, Taylor, you know, do research. How can you help the customer? What is their flow? And another thing that I've heard is, what is the problem that they have that you can solve with your integration? So, last question. What's next for your integration strategy and interests?
I'm fascinated by the future of integrations with artificial intelligence. I think this is such a unique world. Again, I'm all about survival of the friendliest. And we know that with AI usage and good, strong use cases to actually solve problems, it's all about context. And Lucid and Google combined have so much context about people's workflows and work that they're doing. And users spend so much time in both products, right? We're a Google house and I'm in Google all day. I just do so many things there, but I'm also in Lucid all day. And I have so much context in both places. And so thinking about how do we help those tools talk together more naturally for AI? And what kind of things are users going to be needing? What problems do we get to solve here? What things am I not going to have to do in the future because of a better Lucid Google integration that utilizes AI? I think that's a really exciting field that I'm very interested in and hoping to continue to focus on, because I just think the problems there are really compelling and really real. And I'm suspicious of, there's been a lot of problems there that we've all felt, but we've been capped at our capacity to address them because we haven't had the technology we now have with AI and ML. And so I think a lot of us have been like, we know there's these problems, but we couldn't tackle them because we didn't have what we have now. And so I think there's some floodgates that are about to open that are just going to be a lot of fun and very powerful for so many users.
Agreed. Looking forward to that too, to see what happens in the space. And well, I guess we'll have to have you on the show again to tell us what you've built next. So thank you so much, Taylor, for being on the show. And to all of our viewers, do check out the next video. As said, the next Developer Spotlight episode is also about creating Google Workspace add-ons. And thank you so much for viewing this show.